Hey, good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Eric McKinley, and I am the Director of Program Development of National Business Builders. And this is Financial Freedom Friday. So I'm going to give you guys an opportunity to come on board, drop your city, drop your state. Let me know where you're tuning in from, like it and share it. And I am going to do the same. I'm going to like it and I'm going to share it as well. I want you all to hear what it is that I'm about to say, because what I'm about to say is going to make the difference between you actually building your way to wealth and you actually working your way to wealth. So once again, as you jump on, drop your city and your state, let me know where you are tuning in from, like it, share it, and then go a little bit further and tag someone. Tag someone this information, because if you tag someone, you just never know who may need or want this information. Okay, never know who wants this information. So I am a local business owner to Columbia, South Carolina. Our business is located at 9330 Suite C, Columbia, South Carolina. That's Two Notch Road. So if you guys are familiar with Two Notch Road, we're close to the Sand Hill area. And our office has been shut down, but we've not been accepting any groups since COVID. But we've been operating our business mainly online. And I'm going to share the one more group. Okay. We've been sharing our business mainly online. And by doing so, we have created a huge following, because everybody had to adjust because of the COVID. Everybody had to adjust. So you were going to either adjust with the time or you were going to die out. And nobody wants to die out. We want to keep on not just surviving, but thriving as well. Well, here's the thing. There's a lot of business owners out there who did not make the cut. They didn't make the cut because they didn't know what I'm about to share with you. There's a lot of people who have jobs who are out there who didn't make the cut. And they didn't make the cut because they didn't know what it is that I'm about to share with you right now. What I'm about to share with you is something to me that's really simple, but for a lot of people, they're not going to get it. See, you need three things. You need three things to build to be financially free. You need to have three things. OK, three things to be financially free and to build generational wealth. You need to have three things in your repertoire, three things in your knapsack, three things in your purse, your pocketbook or your backpack. Three things. That's it. It's real simple. You need to have financial education. Financial education doesn't come automatically. It's just like reading and writing. It's just like learning your numbers. It's like doing arithmetic. It's like doing math. It doesn't come automatically. You have to go through the process. See, before we were able to learn how to write and read, we have to learn our alphabets. We have to learn how things, how the sounds are made, you know, what letter goes where. Especially in the English alphabet, it's very, very different than any other country. So you got to have that education. And with that education, it's going to become some understanding. And with that understanding, you'll gain some literacy. So that's the first thing you're going to need. You're going to need some financial education. Now, this financial education, most people are going to be looking for this financial education in the traditional setting. They're going to be looking for it in college. You ain't going to get it in college. Even so, there are some high schools that are starting to teach their idea or their form of financial education. But just so we're clear, I want you to understand something. Any educational institution is going to, anything that's structured by the government is going to teach you what they want you to know. So the reason why financial education is not taught in schools is because the government doesn't want us to know. They don't want us to know, because if you become financially educated, you may have more business owners. You may have less employees. And this country is run off of employees' money. Simple as that. So you got to have financial education and you got to look outside of the traditional setting. That means that you're going to have to connect with a circle or a group of people who are not doing what you're currently doing. See, if you're already connected to people who are struggling financially, living paycheck to paycheck, paycheck to Monday, then it's going to be difficult to find what you need to build wealth, to build some freedom. So you got to break away from that. So that's the first thing you're going to need. You're going to need to change your circle, change your mindset, and find some type of financial education. The second thing that you're going to need is you're going to need a home-based business. Yeah, I said it. You need a home-based business. Why? Because a home-based business gives you access to the tax advantages. That's coming up next. A home-based business gives you the ability to legally lower your taxes. Why did I say a home-based business? Well, why not a traditional business? Because a home-based business gives you access to way more tax deductions. Why do we want tax deductions? Because tax deductions allows us to legally lower our taxable income to the legal lowest limit without getting in trouble with the IRS. As long as we follow the rules and play the game the way it's supposed to be played, we're in good shape. See, most people don't understand the benefits of a home-based business, but many people have them. They call them side hustles, and they get their money under the table. Well, we got to get out of that mindset. And if you look behind me, you see, if you can't make it out, it says Generation X. Okay. Generation X. This is a group of people who are near and dear to my heart because I am a Generation Xer. There's so many people in my area, in my lane, in my time zone, in the years that I was born, who are not privy to this information. Because we were taught to go to school and work hard and get a good job. What happened was nobody actually turned us on to financial education. Therefore, we didn't know what we didn't know. Now, there's going to be a lot of smart people that say, hey, all you need to do is work and save and put money aside. That's an old way of thinking. See, savers are losers. I want you to understand something. Savers are losers. Why are savers losers? Because a saver traditionally puts their money in a bank, and a bank is going to give you less than 1% interest. They're going to turn right back around and get 20 to 29 or 30% interest on your money. While they're giving you a calendar, a toaster, and less than 1% interest, they're using your money to build wealth. They're leveraging your money. So you cannot save your way to building financial freedom. You cannot save your way to building generational wealth. You cannot do it. It is impossible. Okay. So we have to change our mindset. We have to have that financial education, which is going to lead to understanding and financial literacy. We have to understand the importance of owning a home-based business. Now, I don't care if you bake cakes. I don't care if you make those cute little desserts in the jars. I love those, man. By the way, there's nothing little about it. That's one of the best things that I think ideas that people came out with or came back with. Okay. I don't care if you make pillows, crochet. I don't care if you do underwater basket weaving. I don't care if you sell rubber bands, pencils, pens, and staples out of your trunk. You don't have to go out and get an LLC to be a sole proprietor. You don't have to go out and get an LLC to be a home-based business owner. Nobody tells you these things because a lot of people want to make you pay for everything. I'm going to give you some free game. Okay. I'm going to give you some free game because now, after giving you this free game, now you can make an informed decision. So the home-based business is going to give you access to all sorts of tax deductions. And you're probably saying, well, you know what, Eric? I don't want to start a business. That's fine. The option is to work until you die. The option is for some people to live paycheck to paycheck or paycheck to Monday. Some people got paid today and will be broke tomorrow. And that's unfortunate, but it doesn't have to be that way. Hey, thanks, Travis, for jumping on. I appreciate it, man. Drop your city and state and let them know you're tuning in from. We want to know where we're reaching out to. You want to make sure you understand that the old ways of doing things are not going to work today. It's not going to work. It's impossible. It's impossible. You cannot work your way to wealth, work and wealth. I'm talking about a job and wealth. That's not synonymous. Work and wealth are not synonymous. You're not going to sell your way to wealth. You're not going to sell your way to financial freedom. See, this is the thing. People tell you, hey, listen, you can make a lot of money if you get into this opportunity or you get into that opportunity. But nobody's telling you what you need to really hear. They're telling you what you want to hear. What you need to hear is this. You need financial education, which turns into understanding and financial literacy. I got to keep on saying that. Then you're going to need to understand why you need a home-based business. a home-based business gives you access to hundreds of tax deductions. Now, you may not get them all, but you get much more tax deductions than you would having a traditional business. Not knocking a traditional business, but it's less overhead. See, I'm in the business of showing people how to keep more money. Thanks, Ms. Cortina, for jumping on out of Huntsville. Appreciate it, Travis, for jumping Waco out there. You just put Waco on the map, bro. So what happens is I'm in the business of helping people to keep more of their money. And while keeping more of your money may not sound sexy, you need to understand this. Keeping your money is saving you money. And money saved is money made. And some of the best dollars that you can save are through your tax dollars. Which leads me to number three. The third thing you need to build financial freedom and to build generational wealth, you got to understand the tax code, ladies and gentlemen. I'm not telling you that you got to read these 77,000 pages. I'm not saying that. But you need to surround yourself around people like myself, people who are in my circle. You know someone in your circle that's talking about money, that's talking about personal finances. Thanks, Ms. K, for jumping on. I appreciate it. Powder Springs. All right. You got to understand, if you don't surround yourself around people who have done what you want to do, it's going to be very, very difficult to build some type of freedom. Miss K said the W-4. Yeah, correcting that W-4 is going to be one of the first steps. Taking your tax dollars back, correcting it, correctly filling it out. The IRS says that 80% of Americans who work a job have that W-4 filled out incorrectly. That means they're losing hundreds of dollars, thousands of dollars a year, hundreds of dollars a month, thousands of dollars a year, and tens of thousands and hundreds of thousands of dollars over a period of about 40 years. I want you to understand something. If you think about this, if you work a job, let's say you work a job from age 25 to age 65, you've worked 40 years. If the government takes about one third of your money in taxes, that means you've paid taxes out of that 40 years, you've paid about 13 years in taxes. How do I know? Because I can multiply. 13 times 3 is 39. So 13 and one third years, you paid taxes out of that 40 years of working a job when you could have had a home-based business, legally lowered your taxes to the legal lowest limit. Hey, Miss Nikki, thanks for jumping on. I appreciate you. To the legal lowest limit. Now you can take those tax dollars, shift them back into your household. Now, when your finances were in disarray, meaning that you may have not had an emergency fund because 69% of Americans don't have at least $1,000 in a savings account or some type of checking account. So now you can create an emergency fund. You may be living above your means. Don't just minimize your expenses. Don't just start saying, hey, I'm going to stop going out to eat. I'm not going to do this and do that. Tell your money where to go. Have an assignment for your money. See, I could stop eating out all day long, but if I don't have anywhere to put the money or don't know how to direct the money, what's going to happen? I'm going to be in a lost state. Minimizing your expenses, minimizing your taxes is going to increase your cash flow. Minimizing, managing, and eliminating your debt is going to increase your cash flow. All that deals with finances, investing, financial education, minimizing your debt, minimizing your expenses, increasing your credit score, building some residual passive income. That is finances. See, many people start talking about finances as in credit. And we're going to talk about that at a later date. But I want you to understand, you need three things to be successful. You need to, one, have some financial education, which is going to turn into understanding and then literacy. You need to have a home-based business. Have a legitimate opportunity where you are attempting to make a profit. That way you can go ahead and move on to the third thing that you need is understanding the tax code, because understanding the tax code is going to take your home-based business and it's going to set you up for success. Keeping thousands and thousands of tax dollars over the period of years, tens of thousands of tax dollars, and you can now strategize your way to wealth. I don't care if you're selling makeup. I don't care if you're selling tea. I don't care if you're selling weight loss. I don't care if you're selling vacuum cleaners. I don't care what you're selling. If you do not have a strategy to keep your money, you will be selling and working until you die. It's as simple as that. So shout out to all my Generation X's, everybody who has a job. Hey, shout out to you. A job is a blessing. However, I want you to understand something. If you really want that job to be a blessing, use it for what God intended it to be used for, to build wealth. See, a good man leaves an inheritance for the children's children. And I ain't met a child yet that can inherit a job. If you got a question about what I'm talking about, or if you want to know more about what I'm talking about, I drop something in the comments, okay? I drop some education. The one that says Financial Freedom Roadmap, that's straight education, okay? That could be shared with everybody. The next thing that's on there, that's a link to my business, okay? So if you want to be involved in what I'm doing, if you want to learn how to keep more of your money, if you want to learn how to build some wealth, if you want to learn some strategies, partner with me. If somebody tagged you, because I see y'all tagging a lot of people. If somebody tagged you, don't even look at my stuff. Get back with them so they can put you on the right track and the right road to financial freedom. Because I don't know about you, but 2020 was a great year for me. It was a great year for me and my family. And it was a great year for the people that are in my circle who actually applied these strategies to their lives. Once again, I'm happy to be here, happy to educate, and happy to share. My name is Eric McKinley, and like I always say, ladies and gentlemen, when you know better, that's when you have the opportunity to do better. And the only knowledge that's powerful is properly applied knowledge. Stop listening to people who have never done what you want to do, been where you want to go, or accomplishing what you want to accomplish. Stop listening to them. I'm telling you. Get a different circle of people. Get people who are going to lift you up. Get people who are going to push you. Get people who are going to challenge you. That's my time, man. Happy Financial Freedom Friday, man. Get with us so we can help you get on the right road and the right track to financial freedom. Y'all have a good day. I see y'all at the top because there's too many people struggling at the bottom. Peace.